As wealthy as he was, as powerful a figure as he was a very influential figure in Quraysh. Although he was slightly younger than Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam, he was influential because he had wealth. Do you know, up to this day, anyone who has a lot of wealth, they are quite influential. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us ease. There was a time we used to say, you know, money talks. Have you heard that? Money talks. But I've actually changed that to money screams. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us ease and goodness, and may He make us from those who understand and realize. So he then accepted Islam, and he was the first from Banu Hashim, which is the direct clan of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam, to accept Islam. And Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam was so happy, but it made certain people very, very upset. Who became angry? Number one was Al-Hakam ibn Abi al-As. Abu Jahl became very angry. He said, how can a man from our clan accept Muhammad? And this man is from a noble home. This man is from a noble home, Uthman ibn Affan. How can he accept Muhammad ibn Abdullah as a messenger of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and quit our ways and our habits? No ways, I'm not going to leave this man. So he started persecuting his own relative. And he told him, I am not going to leave you, O Uthman, until you leave Muhammad. And Uthman ibn Affan radiallahu anhu says, I will never ever quit Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam. I'm not going to quit my deen. Whatever he is calling towards is correct, it is right. Do not let your position, your power, your authority cloud your understanding of what is right and wrong.